I'm gonna do entire screen.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, not
entire. Yeah, that's the.
Yeah, that's
the share. Okay. If you're experiencing issues screen sharing a single prompt tab, we're all doing full screen.
It's not gonna be in
the camera. Okay, put it there. Okay, it is.
Okay, I'm gonna memorize it.
Welcome to the celebration of life of Sherice Dawn Belfie. Sherice Reese Belfie was born on July 23, 1984 to her parents April Dawn Belfie and Shedrick Bernard Powell in Long Beach, California. She is her mother's only child and her maternal grandparents' oldest grandchild. Sherice attended Torrance High School for 2 years, then changed to San Pedro High School for her senior year and graduated in 2002. She then achieved her BA at Smith College in Northampton, Massachusetts. Sherice followed in her mother's footsteps and worked in the auto industry for most of her career. She enjoyed developing and training and worked with hundreds of people over her lifetime. She met the love of her life in 2016. Vic and Sherice married and acquired Liberty, their dog daughter, shortly after. They have lived in Pear Blossom, California since 2017. Sherice made her departure and got her angel wings on August 7, 2021. She is survived by her husband and life partner, Victor Patarroyo, her beloved dog Liberty, Peppers, her mother April Belfie, Madre, and her stepmother Tracy Hawkins, her grandparents, Grampy and Granny, her Aunt Sherry, her first cousin Hannah, Uncle John, and many aunts, uncles, and cousins on both sides of the family. Sherice had no children.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the life celebration of Sherice. I'm her grandfather. We're going to start right now. The family would like to thank you for all your love and support during this difficult time. Also, thank you for being part of this viewing of her celebration of life. I'm going to open with prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you this afternoon, thanking you for your love, peace, and comfort that you have given to us even while we mourn the loss of our precious Sherice. We thank you, Lord, for the 37 years and 15 days that you gave her to spend with us. Yes, we may grieve, but we know that she is in a better place with you now. No more stress, pain, suffering, or sickness. We are grateful for your constant presence with us, dear Lord, during this celebration of life and the difficult days ahead. In Jesus' name, amen. Now I'm going to talk about our beloved granddaughter. She was a beautiful child, happy, loving, friendly, kind, and never heard her complain. She spent a lot of time in this home with us, her grandparents and her Uncle John and Aunt Sherry. John and Sherice would play and wrestle, laugh and scream, and bring joy to the family. We loved hearing them enjoy each other's company. We took Sherice wherever we went, restaurants, shopping, church, family, events, and she seemed to enjoy our time together as much as we did. She loved theme parks, and we had many trips to Knott's to eat and go on the rides. Her mother was working, so she spent a lot of time with us. I took her to our family reunion in Michigan while her grandmother was in Guatemala on a missionary trip. She met my mother, her great-grandmother, and helped her pick wild raspberries and carrots. Her great-grandfather, Grandpa, and I took her to our blueberry farm where we could eat the berries there, and later when returned with the blueberries, great-grandma made a fresh blueberry pie. Great-grandma kept us in plenty of homemade bread, which Sherice loved. While in high school, she played basketball, and while in college, she played rugby and ice hockey. She always helped us, her grandparents, with whatever we needed. Since I don't know much about computers, phones, etc., she was my go-to person. She would have the answers or would call me right back to solve my problem. I learned about Amazon from her and would receive packages with medicine, vitamins, parts to fix something in the house. I could call her at any time of day or night, and she would answer and resolve that issue. Revelation 21 verse 4 states, "And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, no sorrow, no crying. There shall be no more pain. For the former things have been, I'm sorry, right to where? her race is over. No more pain, sickness, or hurts. How about us that remain? Where do we stand with God and with each other? Give roses while people can smell them and appreciate them. Spend time with those you love while you can. Forgive and be forgiven. Let go of the hurts and the bitterness. 2 Samuel 12:23 states, she cannot come to us, but we can go to her. And Sherice, someday we will see you in heaven.
My name is Victor Pateroya. It's hard for me to speak. I've been having a lot of issues with a lot of things right now. I lost my best friend, the greatest person that I've ever known. She was truly everything to me. She was so beautiful. It was really everything. She was everything to me. And she was a rock. I think for the first time in my life, somebody that I could really look up to, you know? This woman loved me so much. I loved her so much. Oh, the raw intensity of the love that we had was, I've never experienced anything before in my life like this in my life. I'm 42 years old. I thought I knew what love was. And then I met this person. And this person completely changed everything that I thought the world was even made out of. And oh man, she could do anything. She could do anything, and she had an answer for everything. Had so many adventures. We went so many places, and we were planning on going so many other places. I would always tell her, wait do you see what we do next? 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 I'm sad, but I'm angry, and I'm jealous of people who get to spend, you know, lives with. This person for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, you know. This wasn't on my radar at all. I was too busy thinking about the things that we were gonna do. We were constantly talking to each other, constantly making plans. God, she was so beautiful. She was so beautiful. Every time I looked at her, I was just in awe. I was in absolute awe all the time. She was such a treasure. The greatest treasure. Oh, she was truly my hopes and dreams moving forward in my life. She was the greatest thing that ever happened to me. And she taught me so much about how to be proud and how to love right, how to be respectful towards others, and really how to love. It was, oh God, I had so much respect for her. I was so proud of her. I would boast about her in front of other people, almost like it was like I was trying to embarrass her or something. She'd be standing right in front of me or right next to me or at the table with somebody. And I'd have to tell them, let me tell you about my wife and how amazing she is. She was the MVP. She was the most valuable player. I think she wanted recognition, you know. I think she wanted the respect of being recognized for the things that she could do and the person she was, you know. She was a woman in a male-dominated industry, or she was part black, or she wasn't thin enough. She looked too young. God, she did look young. She was so beautiful. She had an answer for every question. She prided herself on, like, actually being able to tell somebody, or, you know, the truth, or how it really was. Could implement anything. Implement anything. We need to do this. Okay, it's done. What? I'm sorry. What? It's done. What? That was her. People would try to steal her ideas and steal the respect that was supposed to be towards her, and that would just upset her so much, you know. It was always some reason not to. And she, that was the greatest thing, that she always wanted, just to be recognized. Really, that I hope I can pick up that ball in some way. And I used to think I was like that, like I was a survivor, you know. Oh man, being with this person, completely changed me into almost like a codependent. It was like the most wonderful thing to have somebody like that right next to you all the time. I just knew that she would. I didn't see this coming at all. She was the greatest thing that ever happened to me. Oh God, the greatest thing that ever happened to me. We had so many adventures. We went so many places. We did so many things, and I was looking forward to doing so many more. Thank you to all the people who were watching this, or were in her life. She touched so many people and spread her wings so far. I love you, Sherice. I'm never gonna stop saying your name. When the time comes, I'm gonna call for you. Your name might be the last thing that I ever say.
Say how much I love my son-in-law Vic, and the way that he loved my daughter,
and the way that she loved him. And I know that they found true love together. And we are, our family is committed to being family to Vic, and Vic is committed to being family to us. We have each other. I just want to share a couple of thoughts as her mom. When Sherice was born, I was so scared. I was young, I was a single parent. How could I possibly raise this child by myself? But what I didn't know is God knew I couldn't do it by myself and gave Sherice and I the family and friends that would shape her character and bless her life. When she first came, she was our whole world. She's my only child. She was my parents' first grandchild. And there was just so much joy having a baby in the house. You know, the truth is, I wasn't always the best mom. Sometimes I wonder how she turned out as amazing as she did. She gave me a purpose. You know, so many times I felt like I would have not made it, but I had to. I had my precious Sherice. A little bit later, when Sherice was a teenager, Sherice gave me a gift that I treasure even today, and that is priceless. Sherice and her friend Heidi insisted that I meet their friend from work, Tracy. We found true love because of her. And you know, Tracy and I are 21 years. I know that Vic and Sherice had that kind of love. But I thank you, Sherice. Thank you for finding my perfect partner and bringing her to me. In the last 7 years or so, Sherice and I have become closer than ever. She would call to talk about work issues and get advice on how to handle the situation, or even just call to check on me. "Hey, Madre, how you doing?" She always called me Madre. I remember when she met Vic and how she would tell me she finally had found someone she wanted to be with and love forever. And yes, Madre, we're going to get married. And they got married. And they found true love. Recently, she and Vic would come to Vegas and visit with us, eat, swim, and share our lives. I'm so grateful for these times, and they're precious. Now that she's gone, I'm scared all over again. Can can I be a good mom to Vic? How will I live to make her proud? Is this pain and these tears gonna last forever? I don't know. Our family will support each other, and we will cry together and hurt together. Together, Sherice. We're gonna do it together, Sherice, until we meet again. I love you, kid. I loved being your madre. I miss you so much. You are my heart, my one and only.
Good evening, each and every one of you. I have the privilege of being the grandmother of the greatest woman in the world. This young lady was always our comfort as a baby and honor. Well, first of all, I better stick to the script here. At 10 years old, I'll tell you this story. She was at church with me. We were outside. She had a question for me, and then I said, do you want to accept the Lord Jesus in your heart? And she said, yes. And she said, yes, and we prayed, and she spoke in a heavenly language. This gives me the comfort today, knowing she is with Jesus. When she was in the hospital as a baby and not improving, when she was in the hospital recently and not improving, I knew that I needed to remind her of her decision when she was 10 years old. I texted her and she responded and said, "Yes, Grandma, I know. He is right beside me, helping me to fight." As a very young baby, I would take her to the mall in her big carriage. As she grew older, she was able to be in a stroller and got the attention of everyone because she was such a happy baby and the most beautiful curls were on her head. It wasn't long then when one day with my daughter Sherry and I, we were upstairs in my bedroom and Sherice was with us. But John, her Uncle John, was going to try to scare her. So he started coming up the steps and making the pounding sounds of the steps. And she got so excited and screamed. And she jumped on our laps and hugged us like, "Oh, John's coming." And she played us such a beautiful part, like she was really afraid of him. She just had the game all set up in her mind. And this was so great because everybody loved her and she loved everybody. All right, when Sherice was young, she excelled in all her subjects. She had all the friends. She was the girl that everybody liked because she was so unassuming. And everyone wanted to be around her. Later on, she was accepted at Smith College, as has been mentioned. And she said on her graduation day, before the actual ceremony, she said, "Grandma, I'm published. And she took me up to the department, I believe in the library department of one of the buildings, and she showed me her book. She was quite a poet. She had quite an imagination. And then that was a special honor. She expressed herself so well through her poetry and her little stories. She also loved helping people, as my husband, her grandfather, said. And anytime we needed anything, she was there to give it to us. No good? Was a student at Smith College, and she excelled. She had friends, and there was nothing that she could find to complain about, believe it or not. And I thought, this is an unusual kid. And there's no other way to say it but to say that it was a privilege. It was the privilege of my life to be her grandmother. Not only to take care of her in her early years, but to enjoy her wisdom, her knowledge, and her sense of humor, and her kindness to everyone she met. And I appreciate our family here. We've all enjoyed this, and we thank God for their input. And I know that this will be a great blessing to April and Tracy, too, and each one of you that have helped us. Thank you.
Okay. Hi, I'm Jasmine. I'm one of Sherice's friends, but even more, we looked at each other as sisters. And, well, what can I say? You were so many things to so many people. Daughter, granddaughter, wife, niece, friend, and so much more. Our friendship spanned over 20 years, and we've been through so much together, although neither one of us looks like it. When I was a drunk mess, you made sure I got home. When I was pulling a crazy episode on my exes, you were there with the drinks. When I was ready to move out, you made a place for me and told me to go back home a month later because I was messy and unwilling to work. You were the one who saw the worst in me and still found a way to see the best. My confidant, my ally, and the one person I completely opened up to without shame or boundaries. I'll never forget your laugh, so cute and mischievous at the same time. I'll never forget your sharp mind and our debates about anything and everything. Your terrible taste in B-rated horror movies, just so you could laugh at them while I jumped and screamed. And our shared love of luxury high-end designer brands. We understood each other in a way that only children can understand each other. You're a hard act to follow, but out of everything I've learned from you, the most important thing you taught me was to not settle for mediocrity. I promise to make sure I live that mantra every day of my life. Words haven't even been invented to describe the phenomenal woman you were. You are the Louis Vuitton to my Chanel, and I love you so much. And I'm lost without you, girl. Rest in paradise, baby.
Sherry. I'm Sherice's aunt, and I had the privilege of living here in this home when she was first born, and she truly was the center of our world. And I was known as Auntie Banty Booty. Don't ask me why, but that was my name. And we used to sign cards to each other, TGFY, thank God for you. So those are the two things that go through my mind. Thank God for you, Auntie Banty Booty. Don't anyone ever call me that. I have a birthday card that I never got to give Sherice. And it says, "Niece, you have been a bright spot in our family your whole life." And that's what I want to say. You've been a bright spot my whole life. And I knew you as a baby, an infant, a child. And in this past week, I grew to know who you were as a woman. Your husband, Vic, opened his home, and I shared several beautiful days seeing your life, your empire, everything you built together. And I have a glimpse into the sense of loss that you have left behind. Rest in the arms of the Almighty. You are forever in my heart. April wrote these words, her mother wrote these words, and I'm honored to read them. April says, "I have so many beautiful memories of Sherice, who when she was born was almost named Misty Dawn. I'm glad my family steered me away from that. So we chose Sherice, a blending of Sherry, me, and Shedrick, her father's name. She spent her younger years mostly hanging out with grandparents and Uncle John, who was only 12 years older than her. Once she started school, she met her childhood best friend, Heidi Nardini, in kindergarten. She enjoyed hanging out with the Nardini family and all the different animals they had. She had so much family that loved her in her life. She even got to travel with me, her Aunt Sherry, to visit John, her uncle, in Tokyo. She was 13 and we had the time of our lives. I will always remember that as such a beautiful time getting to know her and treasuring her. As a young teenager, we shared our lives with Lisa Schwab and lived close to the beach. She got her champagne taste and Hollywood from Lisa. At age 13, Sherice went to Alaska to visit her dear friend Bonnie Nicholson, who was our roommate for a while when Sherice was younger. She was hit by a car while riding her bike. I was so afraid I was going to lose her then, but her wings weren't ready. And thankfully she recovered. We moved to San Pedro in 1999. Sherice and Heidi were working for Gable House Bowl and Laser Storm after school and weekends. That's where they met Tracy. They were so excited to have me meet her. Without Sherice, there would be no Tracy and me. She's the one that brought us together. Her senior year in high school, she met her English teacher, Miss Elizabeth Jackson, who was a Smith College alum. This woman saw something in Sherice and wrote a recommendation letter to Smith College admissions. Sherice was accepted and they gave her a scholarship. She loved to travel and see different places, so the East Coast school was perfect for her. She graduated in 2006 and moved to San Francisco for a short time and began to find herself. She returned to SoCal and spent some parts of her life with Joythier, Jamie, Janet, and Taylor. Sherice started working in the automotive industry with me and met Sherry Waters, who took her under her wing. Sherry mentored her and helped her build her skills as she developed her career. They were also close friends and spent time together. She met the love of her life in 2016, Vic, who has become a part of our family over the last few years. They even got a place in Vegas so the four of us could spend time together as a family. I cherish the time we had. Sherice loved her kitties, then her precious dog, Liberty. Tracy and I often said, Sherice is gonna be so rich. She's driven and ambitious. But also, she wasn't the type to step on somebody to get ahead. She was always willing to share her knowledge with others, help coworkers to succeed, and support those of us who are technologically challenged. So many people have shared how Sherice touched their lives. I appreciate all of the kind words her family and friends have shared with us. I don't know how to imagine the rest of my life without her. Please share your memories so we can bask in her light and beauty over and over. Sherice, we honor you, we recognize you, and we respect you. I love you.
She knew me as Ruthie, but she also called me Tiki. You know, Sherice was my biggest fan. I'm in school, I do research and presentations, and any advocacy or cause I was involved in, she was there, and she was supportive and kind. And even though there were times where I felt so discouraged, Sherice would encourage me. One time I had a seminar online and there were three people in the audience and Sherice was one of them. And she was one of those people that she believed in you and she supported you and she was wholehearted and she was kind, but she was also very organized. And if I could summarize the way Sherice is as a person, it was like she came in peace, but she meant business. So right now, I mean, this is probably the most teary-eyed celebration I've ever been to. There's lots of tears because heaven gained the most awesome angel. And she's, you know, heaven, just get ready, because Sherice is the new angel in town. And she comes in peace, but she means business. And it's likely that she's up there right now going, okay, everyone, get in line. There's new technology for all of this. You're all behind, and there's a new spreadsheet for that. And she means business, but she's going to be very nice about it. And she'll say things like, we need world peace. We need a cure for cancer. Things are behind. And I could see all the angels gathering and saying, but Sherice, time here is different. And I could just say, I could just see her saying, really now, there's a new angel in town. So if you feel, for those of us that have lost our angel, if you feel encouragement and somehow wisdom or some kind of guidance or love just from nowhere, I just know it's Sherice. I am so blessed to be her cousin. I am so blessed to have known her. And I'm so thankful for this moment with her family. Because she was my family. And now we'll have our closing prayer. Oh, I believe we have one more speaker.
Before we do the closing prayer, I just want to let you know we have one more video we'd like to share after we do the closing prayer, and we'd like you all to experience that with us. You are all a part of it. We want to say thank you to her cousin Ruthie, to her auntie Sherry, to my parents, my mom and dad, Roger and Emma, to Tracy, to Hannah, to everyone who's been a part of making this possible, to each of you out there who's watching, each of you that have, out of the love of your heart and your care for Sherice and for our family, given of your finances, given of your time, given of your messages, we just want to say as a family, we thank you and we appreciate you. And we hope that you being able to share this day with us feels like a gift back to you. And we appreciate you. And as I said, we're going to have my dad, Roger Belfi, come and say our closing prayer. And then just stay tuned a little longer. Thank you.
I'd like to mention that we are planning sometime next year a larger meeting, a larger gathering, a larger service for our granddaughter Sherice. So we'll send further direction and further communications to you as we plan that day. Now we're going to have the closing prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you at the close of the celebration of life for Sherice. We cry tears as we remember so many special times with her. We grieve but are thankful and rejoice because we know that she is with you in heaven and in a beautiful place where there's no stress, pain, or sickness. We thank you for the peace and comfort you have given to us through this difficult time of sorrow. We ask you to bless the family and all those that knew and loved Sherice and are experiencing the loss of such a caring, loving spirit. And we ask this in the powerful and wonderful name of Jesus. And we say amen together.
Amen.
We're going to be ending the video to start a new live video to show the closing. Yeah, I'll show you that in a second. Go live. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Refresh it in a minute. Hello and welcome back. Oh, here we are. Hello. We are going to do the video. Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much for attending this celebration of life. We appreciate your being here to celebrate Sherice.
Feel free to leave
comments or photos during the comments of the live stream, and it will continue to be on this Facebook page. We will be checking comments, and we truly appreciate you being here to celebrate with us and honor Sherice's life. Thank you.
Okay, so we can
stop this video now.
And then I'll send you all